iOS 17.4 has dropped with plenty of new features, including alternative app stores, and we've also got some updates on the upcoming iOS 18. Now let me know in the comments who's already using iOS 17.4, and don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date with the latest tech. So first up, we're going to run through what's new in iOS 17.4, and first up, we've got the ability to use alternative app stores, a change that Apple had to implement in order to comply with the EU's Digital Markets Act. As of iOS 17.4, users can now sideload applications on iOS using third-party app stores, but as always, it's not as simple as it sounds. For a start, these alternative app stores must follow specific rules to be approved by Apple, and because this is due to an EU act, it's only going to apply to EU countries, and even the UK has been excluded. Now, for those wanting to try and trick the system, it looks like it will be doable, but probably more hassle than it's worth, as Apple are going to be using multiple verifications, including the Apple billing address, the user's current location, the current region, and the device class, as this only applies to iPhones and not iPads. Streaming game apps are no longer restricted to the web only, and they're now allowed on the App Store worldwide, which means that we've got dedicated apps available for things like Xbox Cloud Gaming and GeForce Now. Over in Apple Music, the Listen Now tab has been renamed to Home, and for those of you that listen to podcasts, in the Apple Podcast app, we've now got a transcript available, and it's basically the same as you'd get with lyrics showing the whole transcript where the words are highlighted as they're spoken, and you can also scroll through the transcript and actually press a paragraph that you want the podcast to start playing from. In Safari, we've got a slight change to the UI, and the search bar is slightly wider than it was before. And then we also get third-party browser updates for the EU. And on first launch, after you install iOS 17.4, Safari is now going to show a pop-up that allows the user to select a default browser from the list of most popular browsers available on iOS. And the third-party browsers are also now going to be able to use their own browser engines instead of being limited to WebKit. In the stolen device protection, we've also got an option to require a security delay, either all the time or when your device is away from a familiar location. So you can set the familiar location as places like your home or work, and then security delay would only happen when you're not in those places. Now we've got an update to SharePlay with the Apple HomePad and Apple TV, and you can grant permission to a family or friend to control the music that's playing on the HomePod or the Apple TV. Now, the owner of the HomePod will, of course, require an Apple Music subscription, but the user that's being granted access won't need to have one. We've got the next generation CarPlay coming this year, and in iOS 17.4 code, it refers to many of the new features coming. We've got car camera to display the vehicle's rear view camera. We've got charge for electric vehicles, and this is going to show you the battery level, the charging status, the charge time remaining, and more. We've got a climate app that provides access to the climate controls and it allows you to adjust things like temperature, fan speed, heating, steering wheel, and seats, as well as anything else that the car supports. We've got an app to display the status of the doors, windows, and the boot to let you know if they're open or closed. We've got a media app that's going to deliver access to FM and AM radio controls from within CarPlay. We've got tire pressure that's going to display the tire pressure information, whether it's high pressure, low pressure, or flat. And there's no mention of it, but hopefully we will get tire temperatures as well. Finally, we get a trips app, and this provides your driving data, so your average speed, your fuel efficiency, time elapsed, and distance traveled. Now next up, we've got new emojis added, which includes a lime, a mushroom, a phoenix, a broken chain, and then we've got a shaking head both vertically and horizontally. Automatically send message settings under Siri and search has now been renamed to messaging with Siri. We can now ask Siri to read incoming messages in a specific language, and we get a choice of all these languages here. And this is also not going to update the primary language that Siri listens in and speaks to you in, but it's specifically a choice for the reading of messages. We now have alternative payment options in the EU for apps, and this means that there's no longer a need for in-app purchases within apps. And developers who use alternative payment methods are going to receive a 3% discount in their app fees. And there's also a new system available for calculating the developers' app fees, and it's going to offer them 1 million installs for free, and then 50 cents per user after that. For those wanting the latest information on iOS 18, we had an update from Mark Gurman in his Power On newsletter, and he says it's one of Apple's biggest iOS updates ever, if not the biggest in their history. He advised that we'll be getting a revamped version of Siri, and it's not only more intelligent, but it's also able to take advantage of a new AI system that incorporates large language mobile technology. We're going to be seeing AI integration within the Messages app, and it's going to be able to field questions and auto-complete sentences. We've got new AI features in Apple Music, and this is going to create auto-generated playlists based off the user's preference and listening history. There's going to be generative AI into iWork apps like Keynote and Pages, as well as generative AI features added to Xcode to let developers write new applications more quickly. Now, given the rest of the market this year is also offering a lot of AI tools for searching and generative AI for post-processing images, I imagine Apple is also going to be working on something similar, maybe a little bit of an overhaul of the Photos app. Now, that's all the news we've got for today. But as always, make sure you subscribe for all of the new updates to iOS and more.